الرحمن الرحيم، بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا ومشايخنا وأصحاب الحقوق علينا، اللهم آمين. طب we're continuing إن شاء الله with أحكام التجويد. Last time we finalized أحكام النون الساكنة والتنوين. And both of them are similar in that they involve a noon. One of them is actually written, which is نون الساكنة. The other one is implicit, which you see when you see a تنوين. And we said that النون الساكنة and تنوين have four main أحكام depending on the letter that comes after them. The first one is الإظهار, to pronounce them very clear, where if they are followed by همزة, ها, ح, خ, عين, غين, and we went through the details of how the noon, how the سكون would be written above it, or how the تنوين would be made. The second حكم is الإدغام, merging, which happens if the نون الساكنة or تنوين is followed by six letters, and we split them into ينمو and لام and راء, because if they are followed by ينمو, it's إدغام with غنة. And we said the غنة is a sound that you make from the tip of your nose, which is two harakas long, which is you basically, you count one, two. Whereas if it's followed by لام and راء, there is still an إدغام, which is there is still merging, but there is no غنة. And we said something unique about إدغام is that it never comes in the middle of the word. It has to come at the end of the word. The third related حكم is الإخفاء, which is a middle ground between الإدغام and الإظهار. So you basically hide part of the letter, you still make a غنة, but you don't fully merge the letter. And that's basically the rest of the letters except for the باء. That's why we put 15 letters. You don't have to memorize the entirety of the 15 letters, but you only know them by exclusion. And last but not least is الإقلاب, which is conversion, which happens when the النون الساكنة or a تنوين is followed by a باء, and in that case you convert it into a ميم. That's why it's called conversion. You convert النون الساكنة or تنوين into a ميم. So these were the four أحكام of النون الساكنة and a تنوين. Any questions before we proceed? Yes. Yeah. Yes, it has to come at the end of the word. So actually, both. So for, that's why when they say, for instance, the example is صنوان. قنوان. Those two words, for instance. Technically, there is a sukun here on the top of the noon. And that's followed by a waw. Same here. There is a sukun followed by a waw. If I wanted to apply the hukm, I would make idgham. But the problem of applying idgham in the middle of the word is you change the structure of the word. If I apply idgham here, I would say sinwan, that's a different word. Qinwan, that's a different word. That's why the idgham only is applied when it is not in the middle of the word. When it is happening at the end of one word, the noon second or tanween coming at the end of one word, and then the noon, and then the one of these six letters is followed by it. It's following the noon second or tanween. Whereas the ikhfa can happen both in the middle of the word, and it can also happen at the end of the word. And that's why one major differentiation between al-idgham and al-ikhfa, especially when it comes to the noon, al-tanween is easy. Al-tanween is coming at the end of the word anyway. But if there is a noon that does not have a haraka above it, we say ariyatun min al-tashkil. Doesn't have a tashkil above it, and it's coming in the middle of the word, automatically it's ikhfa. It cannot be idgham. Okay? So, does this answer your question? Okay, inshallah. Good. Of course there is a ghunna. All of these, that's a good question. All these three, there is a ghunna. Ghunna. I'm good with what I have. Jazakallah khair. I'm good with what I have. Jazakallah khair. All of these needs ghunna. We're good as we are. Alhamdulillah. Idgham is ghunna. Ikhfa needs ghunna. And iqlab also needs a ghunna. Okay? Idhar, automatically there is no ghunna. Okay? Any questions? So, what we want to cover today is a much simpler and shorter hukm. Inshallah. That is still a noun, but also we're combining with it another letter that's very closely related to it, which is الميم. أحكام النون والميم المشددتين. Which is basically what do you do when you have a noon or a meme that has a shadda on it. It is very simple, whether it's a shadda with fatah, shadda with kasr, or shadda with dham. The hukm is the same. It is, you make a ghunna with haraktain. The hukm is ghunna. مقدارها حركتين. غنة, there is two حركة long. And we say حركة is you count one, two. That's what we mean by the حركة. Okay? Simplest example like سورة الناس. قل أعوذ برب الناس, right? الناس. مالك الناس, إله الناس, من شر الوسواس الخناس. So, قل أعوذ برب الناس. غنة وحركتين because there is a noon مشددة. من شر الوسواس الخناس. إن. If we're talking about the meme. من. So any noon or meme it has a shadda, regardless of it is being a shadda with fatah, or shadda with kasr, or shadda with dam, your hukm is the same. It is ghunna, that is two haraka long. As simple as that. And again, the tajweed classes usually start with ahkam al nun sakina. Assalamu alaykum, al-hawad. Nun sakina and the tanween, and then it's followed by nun wal meem mushaddadatayn, because these are very commonly occurring in the Quran. Very prevalent. It's very rare to find a one pager of the Mushaf that doesn't have at least once of these ahkam. That's why they always start with it. And we have many other examples. We can go through them. Like let's Surah Al-Qari'ah. أَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ. That's another example. The word جهنم always have this hook. جهنم. Another example of الميم. We talked about فأما. سورة القارعة again. فأما من ثقلت موازينه. That's it. That's the hukm. As simple as that. الميم والنون المشددتين. If they have Shadda, the meem and noon, if they come with a shadda. Now remember, why, how is this different from the previous hukm? The previous hukm was talking about a noon is sakina that does not have a haraka. This one, the noon has a haraka, but it is also accompanied by a shadda. And remember, the shadda is technically combining two letters into one. When you say an-nas, technically it is like this. You have the first one. That has sukun. The second one has a fatha. An-nas. An-nas. That's the shadda. Okay? So here, last time we talked about the noon sakina. Today, inshallah, we're talking about the noon al-mushaddada wal-meem al-mushaddada. And their hukm is simple as that. Ghunna miqdaruha harakatayn. Any questions about this? I don't want to go further, but let's just stop and start reading and apply so that we kind of firm the rules of today and keep applying the rules that we have taken the previous weeks. Any questions or concerns here? Clear, inshallah? Okay, jazakum Allah khair. Let's start reading, inshallah. Should we start, stop the recording? هذا وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.